Rack and pinion actuator, anodized aluminum, assembled to a Dixon ball valve. Remove the stop pin, handle nut, and spring washer from the ball valve. Secure the valve in a vise. For normally open, leave the valve open. For mounting fail closed, close the valve. Use a caliper to measure the valve stem and the square drive on the actuator. If the stem is smaller, use a square or star sleeve insert. Insert the sleeve into the actuator with the same orientation as the valve stem. Use a caliper to measure the ISO 5211 dimension on the valve pad and on the actuator interface. Select the matching holes. Insert matching set screws to the selected bolt circle on the actuator pad. The sleeve could also be mounted to the valve stem prior to installation. Place the actuator on top of the valve pad. Flip the valve assembly in the vise. Assemble a flat washer, a lock washer, and a nut to each of the four set screws and tighten securely in a star pattern. Assemble an air fitting and an air line to the actuator body. Apply 80 psi to rotate the ball. If the ball is out of alignment, adjustment will be required. Turn over the assembly. Loosen the stop nut and exhaust the air supply to reduce the force on the stop screw. Adjust the stop screw. Add air, check the ball position, and repeat as necessary. Alignment is complete. Secure the stop screw and tighten the nut. Exhaust the air supply. For adjustment in the closed position, use the right stop screw. For fail closed assembly, remove the indicator so that it matches the flow path of the ball. Assembly is the same for both spring return and double acting actuators.